For years, poor, ignorant fools like me have been asking why so many feminists and leftists have nothing but praise for Islam when Islam allows men to beat their wives into submission and to marry prepubescent girls and to have sex slaves and to hire prostitutes and so on. These feminists and leftists assured us not only that Islam was wonderful for women and girls, but also that Muhammad was one of the greatest feminists who ever lived. Sadly, we didn't believe them. We were too focused on actually reading what Muhammad said. But as it turns out, the feminists and leftists were right. Islam liberates women. For example, in the past, in Indonesia, women had to sit on the sidelines and watch men do all the flogging. But now, women in Indonesia aren't merely spectating or being flogged. They're carrying out the floggings. That's progress. AFP reports. The masked woman nervously approaches her target. She ain't the only one who's nervous. Shuffles into position and then unleashes a flurry of lashes, proving herself as the newest member of the first female flogging squad in Indonesia's Aceh province. The new recruit initially needed some coaxing to punish the offender, an unmarried woman caught in a hotel room with a man. Such behavior constitutes a morality crime in Aceh, the only region in the world's biggest Muslim-majority nation that imposes Islamic law, known as Sharia. Those found guilty of breaches are often publicly whipped with a rattan cane. But despite her reticence, she persevered and delivered her first flogging. Atta girl. I think she did a good job. Her technique was nice, Banda Aceh Sharia Police Chief Investigator Zakwan, who uses one name, told AFP. This guy goes by one name. Apparently, Sharia police are the rock stars of Indonesia. I'm surprised Zakwan doesn't have his own reality show. The controversial punishment enrages rights activists, aka Islamophobes, and generates heated media debate as well as amongst politicians. Indonesia's president has issued a call for the public floggings to stop, but he has little say over what happens in Aceh, a deeply conservative region on Sumatra Island. Unlike the rest of the nation, Aceh follows religious law as part of a 2005 autonomy deal agreed with the central government that ended a decades-long separatist insurgency. Here, public whipping remains a common punishment for scores of offenders for a range of charges, including gambling, adultery, drinking alcohol, and having gay or premarital sex. But the job has always been done by men. Until now. Wow. First, women in Saudi Arabia were given the right to drive. Now, women in Indonesia have been given the right to publicly flog other women. What's next? Sending a female astronaut on one of the numerous Islamic space shuttles headed to the moon? More and more women are being charged for morality crimes such as public affection or premarital sex, experts say, as greater internet access and globalization bring clashes with local cultural and religious norms. Enforcement, too, has increased, and now Aceh says it's trying to follow Islamic law, which calls for women to whip female perpetrators. That's debatable. This is already what happens in neighboring Malaysia. Good old Malaysia, still on its way to becoming a Sharia-topia. But convincing women to participate has been no easy task, and it's taken years to assemble the first female squad, according to Safriyadi, who heads provincial capital Banda Aceh's Sharia Implementation Unit. Women need to step up in Indonesia. When the Sharia police announce that they need male floggers to flog women, men line up for miles. But when they say that they need some female floggers on the flogging force, women just don't show up. For some strange reason, women just don't seem to want to pick up a rattan cane and start lashing other women and girls. Ladies of Indonesia, For 14 centuries of your religion, men have been beating women, husbands beating their wives, Sharia police lashing women and girls for walking down the street without a male escort. Don't miss your chance to join the men in beating your sisters into submission. 8 women, all Sharia officers, agreed to be floggers and were trained in the appropriate technique and advised how to limit injury. Previously, a dozen men performed all the whippings in the city for an unspecified fee. For security reasons, Aceh officials declined to let AFP speak with the floggers, who are outfitted in cloth masks and loose-fitting brown uniforms to hide their identities. We train them to make sure they're physically fit and teach them how to do a proper whipping, Zakwan said. Zakwan has women in the gym doing calisthenics to get them in shape for all the public lashings. But the secret for any whipping is getting past the mental hurdle of lashing fellow citizens. For that, you need to look to God, Zakwan said. It's kind of an indoctrination that we give to them so they have a better understanding of their role. Have no mercy for those who violate God's law, he added. No mercy.
No mercy.
So, according to the Aceh School of Public Flogging, trainees need to be not only physically fit, but also mentally fit. But they can only be mentally fit by focusing on the great God Allah. Good advice for those of you who are interested in pursuing a career in the rapidly growing field of flogging rebellious women. Hit the treadmill, build up your cardio. Don't forget to work your shoulders and arms and back. Do some stretches. And above all else, study Islam's most trusted sources so you can learn to show no mercy to those who violate Allah's law. Train your body, train your mind, and maybe you can be Indonesia's next top flogger. Hashtag Islamic goals.